You have approximately 171 billion total brain cells. 86 billion of these are neurons that process information, sense various stimuli, and make you, well, you. But are there things in everyday life that reduce this count? What will kill your brain cells? We used to think the brain couldn't produce new neurons. Although neurons are a stable cell type, meaning they don't multiply themselves, we now know that new neurons are produced from neural stem cells throughout our lifetime. But this happens only in certain areas of our brain, mainly in two small regions in the forebrain. So while we can make new neurons, brain cell death in large amounts may be dangerous and irreversible. For example, within 5 minutes of a good blow to the head, axons are compressed and calcium rushes into your neurons, which can signal a number of different pathways and enzymes to begin cell death. This may explain the confusion, loss of consciousness, and sensitivity to sound or light common in a concussion. Getting enough Z's? Although our brain can react against short-term sleep deprivation, a 2014 study showed that too many all-nighters may be killing neurons in the locus coeruleus. This is a region of the brain responsible for coordinating motivation and maintaining attention and arousal, and after extended wake periods, we become unable to make important proteins to keep these neurons alive. But don't stress about that, literally. Long-term stress has been associated with damage to our hippocampus and a reduced ability to make new neurons, which may explain why extreme stress can lead to numerous mental illnesses like depression, anxiety, PTSD, and schizophrenia. Nicotine affects the hippocampus as well, cutting the creation of new neurons by 50% while also increasing cell death. Like the smell of gasoline or permanent markers, although they don't cause brain damage directly, some of the chemicals in them are asphyxiants, meaning they will displace oxygen from the air you breathe and deprive your tissues of oxygen, ultimately killing brain cells. Carbon monoxide, commonly released from stoves, furnaces, grills, and cars, works the same way. By hijacking your hemoglobin, which normally carries oxygen in your blood, cells in major organs like the brain and heart will suffocate and die at high enough levels. But what about alcohol? It appears that short-term exposure to alcohol doesn't kill brain cells, but it can reduce communication between them. And over a longer period, chronic alcohol consumption can activate immune cells in the brain to produce pro-inflammatory chemicals and free radicals that can lead to cell death. Alcoholics can also develop a B vitamin thiamine deficiency called Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome, which can kill off brain cells and lead to memory problems, amnesia, and a lack of muscle coordination. Taking a break from drinking may be the best way to promote neural stem cell growth and other factors for neurogenesis. But no matter how much we might fear losing brain cells, we may have no choice in the matter. Our brain declines by 5% of its volume per weight per decade after the age of 40, with the rate increasing around the age of 70. Most widely experienced is memory loss, which can be a normal part of aging. Overall, we shouldn't be kept up at night wondering how many brain cells we lost today, as losing them may be a sign that things are all right. During development, we produce many more neurons than we need, and brain cells have to die to maintain the brain's complex organization. Research in rats suggests that we lose neurons in our prefrontal cortex as a way of reorganizing our brain during and after puberty. More neurons doesn't necessarily make for a better or smarter person, and sometimes cell death makes for a healthy life.
Thank you so much to Science Sam for narrating this video. You need to follow her on Instagram at science.sam. She'll make you really inspired by science and also even more interested in your brain. Noah doesn't kill your brain cells podcasts, so you should listen to ours. We just released our first ever live podcast from Just for Laughs in Montreal. We were super nervous. I think we pulled it off. Let us know what you think using the hashtag SideNotePodcast, and we'll see you next week for a new science video. Peace.